And it was almost like he was surprised to be that wide open, yet he knocked it down.
Park, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
Shot is good, and the Los Angeles leads. Cut down now to just three on the bucket from Buttinger.
Very effective screen to set up the jumper. That was the key to that play.
And stolen by Napier. Buttinger with it, and it's Lynn picking him up. Here's Napier. Four on the shot clock. Launches a three, and the Heat another three. Face,
a wide open three.
Back
they need much better communication defensively.
Outside, Lynn. Pass to Bryant. Outside, Lynn. All alone. The shot will not go. And it's Miami the other way.
There's no getting around the simple fact that that's a shot he has to knock down.
Feeds it to Buttinger. He kicks to Oden. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation.
You know, one thing you have to give Coach Eric Spoelstra credit for is he's not wedded to just one approach. I like his ability to be flexible. You remember after the 2011 finals, for example, we really went back to the drawing board and changed Miami's offense to their small ball approach, but also wanted to get LeBron inside more. The result has been a couple of championship rings. I tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
Hill, he's checked in for the Lakers. Boozer comes in for Ryan Kelly. Ryan passes to Hill. Ranger again is Bryant. Shot to end this cold run. Shot's good. Kobe's got 14 points. And talk about Coach Spoelstra staying open to new ideas. He spent time in the summer studying football coaches and their techniques.
Yeah, kind of an interdisciplinary interest in greatness. And, you know, that's what goes into building a champion. Spoelstra, very intense and focused, always trying to find an edge, even if he has to kind of step outside the box a little bit.
Lynn kicks to Kobe. And he banks in the layup. And it's a four-point Los Angeles lead.
Heads up, aggressive play right there. He saw the smaller man on him, took it straight to the basket.
Passes it to Nate. Wade kicks to McRoberts. Pass to Nate. Wade outside. Puts up a three. Another miss by Wade.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those two in the first quarter.
Ryan again, it's Wade. He's feeling it. Rebound by the Heat. Anderson's got his fifth rebound in this one. Here's Napier, defended by Lynn. Wade with no one around. Another miss by Wade. Ranger against Slan. He feeds it to Hill. Hill left side. Outside, Kobe. And there's the feed to Korver. Outside, Kobe. The second chance effort. Again, the miss by Kobe. The Heat trailed by four. Park some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
And it's Wade penetrating. Wade right side. Trying to get back on track. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim.
It's been a real difficult game for him offensively, and it's costly.
Outside, Lynn. Boozer wide open. What a play! He simply drains it in at the buzzer.
And an ideal fit.
The clock runs out, and we're heading to halftime. Lakers ahead, up by six. We're going to step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after our halftime. And it's been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now.
You look at Kobe Bryant in this game, I mean, he has been everywhere.
You know, he spoils us with his performances game in and game out. And so far, just another big scoring night for him.
Typically, when he puts up that many points in the first half, he's going to follow it up with a better second half. We'll see if that happens here.
We've got Chris Anderson. Buttinger is out there with Napier. Then there's Danny Granger. And it's McRoberts in a power forward. So that's who Eric Spoelstra starts the second half with.
Risky shot there. Size-wise, I mean, he easily comes out on the short end of the stick, so to speak.
With the nice high release, he had no problem getting it off and knocking it down.
And Buttinger gets it to go.
D there, guys, was pretty much non-existent. I mean, you can't leave a good shooter like that open.
Shabazz Napier, leading UConn to a national championship last season, showed he...
Watch out! Oh, what a throwdown there. And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game right now.
Clark, there is a swagger out here on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either.
That's right.
Those are phenomenal dunks to watch. So much fun. Chase Buttinger, former volleyball star, still has that leaping ability, but has dealt with a knee issue over the last couple of seasons. He's trying to get back to 100%.
And Buttinger, when healthy, Clark, a good floor spacer from three-point range.
You know, he's got good lift on the shot, and of course he's able to finish above the rim as well. He's been a solid defender and rebounder, too.
Here's what Miami's going with right now. Chris Bosch has checked in for Josh McRoberts. Chandler Parsons comes in for Danny Granger. And it's Norris Cole in for Napier. The Heat trail by six. Anderson outside. Left side, Bosch. The Heat need to get a shot off. Buttinger, no luck.
Boy, I'm shocked he didn't make that one. He usually knocks that one down with ease.
Right side, Bryant. And a wide open look for Lynn. Swiped it away. Oh, and a fast break for the Heat. And it's Buttinger.
That's someone give you a fucking ball, dude.
That's how you make it happen, guys. Ball pressure and then a run out.
And those are the kind of plays that will turn that deficit into a lead quickly. So solid defense on the ball, that's the key.
And the Lakers call time here.
Norris Cole played his college ball at Cleveland State and was a state champion at Dayton Dunbar High School. He's a quick scoring guard who the Heat bring in off the bench not only to push the tempo offensively, but to provide some real havoc defensively.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Eldon Brands checked in for Hill. Rando comes in for Boozer. And it's Nash in for Jeremy Lin. It's Brand with the drive. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. And Norris Cole, Steve, more a scoring guard than a playmaker.
Yeah, he picks his spots, Kevin. You know, still searching for that efficiency offensively that would put him over the top, but really found a niche for himself alongside Wade in Miami.
And the second free throw, good.
Elton Brand always deceptive with his wingspan. Standing 6'9", he's a quality defender at the center position thanks to his 9'2" standing reach.
And Cole gigs to Parsons. He dishes it to Anderson. Stolen by Brand. Outside Bryant. Randall with a screen for Kobe. Kicks it to Brand. That's good, and it's Bryant with the assist. And for Brand defensively, Clark, a wide frame, and he catches shooters off guard with those long arms.
And you know, he's still a good rebounder and shot maker from mid-range, Kevin. He's no longer the all-star post threat of his younger days, but he's still contributing as a nice role player.
Parsons attacking. The kick out to Bosch. Dishes it to Cole. The pass to Anderson. Feeds it to Cole. Six to shoot. Stolen by Brand. Nash outside. There's the dish to Brand. Six to shoot. Back to Nash. Puts it up from 12.
It's a suspect.
And a fast break for the Heat. Cole's got the ball. That's good.
Well, he wasn't fazed at all by the bigger man on him. And on the low block, I thought he might be.
You know, Steve, I thought maybe he'd prefer to bring him out to the perimeter. But whatever works, go to it.
Nash, left side. Outside, Kobe. Fires, high post. And the shot is good. Bryant got 4 points this quarter.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the league.
And it's Budinger in the corner. Knocks down the three ball. Budinger's got 9 points here in the second half.
He'll start with
well,
this
after all those struggles
in
the first half, he has really picked it up here in the second.
Randall with a screen for Nash. Pass to Randall. Now here's Nash. D right on him. Let's it fly. No luck. And the Heat going the other way now. Here's Cole, defended by Nash. Budinger, no luck. Lakers leading by 4. Randall kicks to Bryant.
I didn't want to do that, man.
Rebounded by Bosch.
Why make me do shit I don't want to do, TK?
Bosch has got 5 rebounds tonight. There's a good screen. Passes it to Budinger. Wide open. It's stolen by Bryant. Here's Korver. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. Korver's got 5 points so far. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Lakers.
Boy, defensively, they've played with a high energy level, guys, and all the steals we've seen, really a result of that aggressiveness.
Something else they've done is force a lot of mistakes defensively, and they've been turning those turnovers into points.
I'd love to see them impose their will a little bit more on the backboard. Usually that's a great way to take control of a game.
Well, they haven't been able to do that yet, but it's something they're certainly capable of.
Boy, I love to see Steve Nash shoot the ball. I can watch him all day long.
Here's Cole, defended by Nash. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Steve Nash. That's foul number 2 for him. And the Heat going with the whole new group on the floor. Nick Young's checked in for the Lakers. Clarkson comes in for Kobe.
Dwayne Wade, a Hall of Fame player, I think. Held back by bone bruises and tendonitis in his knees in recent years. But you know, by keeping them in good shape and staying in condition, he's been able to.